Today we're talking about soap bottles or oil bottles. It just depends on which one we put in there. We got a soap bottle or we have an oil bottle. I like it when I'm making a soap bottle to be a little shorter and fatter bottle, and an oil bottle to be a little taller and thinner, but however, you're allowed to like what you like. So I'm just going to throw a soap bottle, a short fat bottle, and they're just basically a vase, but a vase without any flare on the neck. They're just straight neck so they can hold and support the cork. So this is going to be a short fat bottle, and I'll show you in a minute how to measure for the cork to fit. Open the way I always do, and I centered it before you got here. You guys don't want to watch me center. So I'll pull my middle finger to the palm of my left hand. Both hands go up together. And I'm just going to go tidy up my bottom a little bit and pull up. This is about a pound of clay or 450 grams of clay. It's not a lot of clay. You don't want a great big bottle. Well, I don't want a big bottle. As I said, you're allowed to like what you like. I like the smaller one. And I'm gonna push out the belly. Now that I'm pushing out the belly, my fingertips are just right across from each other. They're just kind of dancing together as the clay goes out. Go in there and clean up the water because I'm going to close it up and we don't want to trap any water in there. And then I'm going to close it in. And I call this 6-point cuddling because it's 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I know it's technical pottery talk. Actually, I just like the way 6-point cuddling sounds. It sounds so cute. So push it in and up. When you push in, you have to go up. Your clay has to have somewhere to go. So now I'm just going to pull up a neck. And I got some action happening on the top of that. I'm just going to cut that off. Now right now it's far too small to put a cork in. So I'm going to tidy it up. Open it up a little bit. If you make the opening of your bottle with a V shape and your cork is a V shape, it'll fit in there somewhere. And keep in mind, you're going to lose about 15% of your size in the shrinking. So that's down there pretty good. I know that's, again, technical pottery talk. I like it to fit all the way kind of down inside, so then when it's finished, it'll stick up a little higher. When you're done, if your cork fits all the way down on the bottom, it's really hard to get it out, and you fill it up full of soap once and then you're done. So okay, we're gonna tidy that up a little bit. I think I'm gonna leave it at that size. I've got my chamois here. When I throw these smaller bottles and pieces on the wheel, I throw them with the intent of they come off finished. I'm gonna chamois the edge so it's a nice smooth edge. I'm going to cut this excess off the side. Then I got a nice place to keep my needle. And tidy it up with my stick. Now you can leave it with that profile. Sometimes it's nice to just to stick your finger in there. Support your neck. I'm supporting right under here. I'm going to run this little rib up the side. Just give it a smooth... And there we go. I'm just going to move that under there a little bit to undercut it. And now this is trimmed. It is, it's undercut, it's smoothed, it's chamoyed. So now when I cut it off, I'm going to set it on a board. I always put it on a board with paper, so if it sticks to the paper comes off, it doesn't stick to the board. And when it's a little bit dry, I'll sponge it off and sign it. And it's done, and I'm just going to cut it off with a bit of water, pull that wire under there, and put it on the board with the paper. So there we have a short, fat soap bottle. Now we're going to make the oil bottle. It's a little bit taller and thinner than the short, fat soap bottle. And I've got this centered, and I'm going to open it up, as I said, much the same as I open everything else up. I'm going to go tidy up the bottom a little bit, move my middle finger to the palm of my left hand, and everybody comes up. I like it to be a little taller and thinner. At the end, I'll show you why. So we're just going to throw a tall, thin cylinder And this is the same amount of clay as I had for the short fat guy. It's about 450 grams or about a pound of clay. And I don't like a big olive oil bottle on my counter. I don't use a lot of oil. And then you just have a little bit on your counter and the rest of it can sit in the fridge and it waits. And it lasts for a long time. Okay, so now I've got enough water down there. I could swim. I'm just gonna go in there and clean it up. Give my bottle a little bit of tummy and then close it up. Again, as in the soap bottle, my fingertips are right across each other, working together. And then I'm gonna clean it up again there. Not enough to swim, but enough to clean up. And I'm gonna cozy in and up. We're gonna do our 6-point cuddling, our technical pottery talk. When you're pulling it up, when you're pushing it in, you have to pull up. The clay has to have somewhere to go. Going messy is somewhere to go. The top went messy, I can just get rid of that. Not a big deal. And tidy that off a bit. Okay, so I'm just gonna give that a little definition here. I'm gonna give this one a little bit longer neck because we don't have the cork to fit in there. You can do what you like. I'm just gonna, there we go. It's a little bit taller, thinner bottle. Oh, if tall and thin were only that easy. Okay, so let me measure. Let me just tidy it up a little bit. It's a little thick on the neck. Tidy that up. Now before I tidy up too much, I'm just going to measure for size. Keep in mind you're going to lose that 15%. You do have quite a bit of play in these corks. And I think I want it just a little bit bigger. And again, like the soap bottle, you want to have it as a bit of an angle. So you have, again, as it goes down in that, you have play in there. Okay, so I think I've got it the size that I want. And I'm going to undercut it with the needle. Now you can run the rib up the side if you like. Sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. I did on the short fat guy. I'm not going to bother with the tall thin guy. It's not that tall and thin. I'm just going to tidy it up. And the rib is one of those things you're allowed to like what you like. I just want a bit more definition. And the bottles with the straight up neck are kind of plain. But you put a cork in it and some fancy glaze and they're marvelous. I'm just gonna chamois it off. And like the short fat soap bottle, when this guy comes off the wheel, it's done. Let it dry. And yeah, that'll fit about right. So, okay, so now the last thing I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna give it one more little undercut with this stick. So now it's trimmed, it's smooth, it's chamoyed. But I mentioned I'm gonna show you how to make it more comfortable in your hand. So all you wanna do is just, because it's gonna fit in your hand, is just give it a little bit of a squeeze. And I'm gonna turn around and give the other side a little bit of a squeeze so it fits comfortably. Now that will quite often knock your top off. So just give it a quick throw. And now it's comfortable in your hand. It's ready to take off the wheel. And now you're tall bottle is done. I'm gonna put it on the paper with the short fat guy. They can dry and there'll be buds in the kiln. If you enjoyed watching me make the tall guy, well, he's not that tall, and the short guy, he's not that short. If you like watching the soap bottles and the oil bottles, please hit the like. If you want to see me make more stuff, hit subscribe. If you have anything you'd like to share in the comments section, please do. I'd love to hear from you. And thanks ever so much for watching.